Hey everyone! In our latest video, we analyzed TSM Haunter's chase for Xyrelia, where he constantly shoved her into tower and harassed her when the wave crashed. This is how every ranged top laner needs to play the lane, since they rely so much on auto attacks for harass. If they don't push, minions will trade back with them too much. So, in this video, we're going to analyze a game where Gen G's top laner Cuvée, the ranked 59th player in Korean solo queue right now, is playing Akali versus SKT's top laner Tao's Jace and completely counters his game plan. So, let's take a look at this matchup. Akali is a melee assassin versus Jace, a ranged bruiser. Jace has more ranged, more poke, more wave clear, and more burst damage before level 6. While Akali has more health and mana sustained from her Q healing and the fact that she uses energy instead of mana. This is important because this means Akali can spam her abilities on the wave if she wants to, while Jace will run out of mana if he tries to do the same. Another really important part of the matchup is that Akali has an actual ultimate at level 6 and Jace doesn't. So Jace has more wave clear, but it will cost him too much mana to use that to his advantage. If we jump back to the Haunter video, his three missions were this. Mission 1, get the push lead, then last hit to build a wave. Mission 2, harass when they go for CS, and Mission 3, don't die to ganks. And since Cuvée knows that's how Jace needs to play the lane, his game plan looks like this. Mission 1, thin the wave. He knows Jace is going to try to push him in, so he wants to thin the wave as much as he can so Jace can't crash a big wave into his tower. Mission 2, avoid taking too much poke. Jace wants to harass every time Akali goes for CS. He can use this to bait out Jace's abilities by faking going for CS or just giving it up if he needs to. Mission 3, get to level 6 and all in. Like I said, Jace doesn't have an actual ultimate, so if he doesn't get ahead before Akali hits 6, that's when Akali can start taking over the lane and get aggressive. Alright, let's get into the gameplay. As the lane begins, Cuvée walks up to the minions and starts mission 1 right away by auto attacking this minion. This might seem small, but any damage you can get on the minions helps when you know you need to thin the wave. He lets Jace walk up and auto him, then uses his Q on the melee minions. He did this because if Akali has at least 180 energy, her Q gives her health back, so he wanted to wait for Jace's poke before using her first Q to heal, or it would have been a waste. He waits for his energy to regen back to 180, then grabs these two minions with his Q, putting him back at 100% health. And then uses another Q to harass Jace, grab a last hit, and hit the ranged minions at the same time. Now that the wave is pushing for him, it gives him the freedom to walk up and grab CS. If he didn't do all of this wave thinning already, the wave would be big for Jace, and Jace could go hammer form all in with the big wave backing him up. But if he tries to do that right now, Akali has the bigger wave, making it so he can only hit her with an auto attack before having to back up. As Jace goes to last hit a few minions, Akali uses that time to auto. Basically, he's using any free time where he can't be punished to get any damage he can on the minions, especially because when it's a melee versus ranged matchup, it's almost impossible to actually outpush Jace, as he can auto the wave as much as he wants. Tao pokes Cuvée with an auto, drawing minion aggro to himself, so as he's backing away to drop aggro, Cuvée uses that time to use two Qs on the wave for the heal and to continue mission 1. Right now, the lane is going very well for Cuvée. He's preventing any kind of push from Jace and staying healthy. He just needs to make sure he doesn't die to the jungler, putting all of this work to waste. After he puts the ward down, he goes back to mission 1 and uses Q to grab a few minions, then uses Shroud to grab the rest. I'm sure some of you are thinking, if he doesn't want Jace to push, why doesn't he just spam Q on the wave and push Jace into his tower? Well, if he does that, Jace will have the tower to defend him and help him clear the wave, meaning Jace can freeze and Akali would have a hard time breaking it. And she could potentially die to a gank. He would rather have the wave closer to the middle of the lane. Anyways, as he's coming out of his shroud, he uses his last Q on Jace for some poke. The wave is pretty close to even right now, so he's not in too much danger of the wave pushing. But since he's out of energy, he needs to back off. Then he walks up and uses Q on Jace and the minions, healing him a little bit, but ends up not having enough damage to finish off the minion he was trying to get. This is where mission 2 comes into play. Even though the minion was really low, if he walks up to grab it, that's when Jace could punish him hard and he would take a ton of damage because he's walking into the enemy wave. So he lets that minion go. If you don't know, Akali's shroud restores 40 energy. So when Cuvée uses his shroud here, he uses it first to bring his energy up for the Q heal, thins the wave, then grabs a few last hits from the safety of his shroud. This is a concept that a lot of players struggle with and it's fairly simple. When you're playing a champion without mana, don't be afraid to use big cooldowns like this. We will see this throughout the lane. He constantly uses Shroud for the energy and to grab CS. But after using a big cooldown, you have to respect that the enemy laner could be looking to get aggressive during that time. So Cuvée backs up when his Shroud goes away, respecting that Jayce could all in him before the next wave shows up. The next wave shows up now, and instead of using Q to grab the cannon, he realizes that Jayce is walking up to harass him when he goes for it. So he uses Q on Jayce, then autos the cannon minion as Jayce backs away to drop minion aggro. The wave is starting to build up, so Kali uses Q on the melee minions first, then pops Shroud and walks up using Q on the ranged minions as well. He knows if he doesn't thin the wave out now, the wave will be too big when the next wave arrives and it will be impossible to thin it. While he's doing this though, his jungler Lee Sin shows up for a gank, so instead of finishing clearing the wave, he tries to bait Jayce into getting aggressive. Sadly, Jayce doesn't fall for the bait and backs off. This was actually pretty bad for Cuvée. He lost a lot of health, time, and energy that he could have been using to keep the wave thinned out. And now the next wave is here, with him having only 40% health. They're both playing pretty safe now, letting their potions work and heal them back up. But the wave is starting to build again, so Cuvée uses a Q to kill a few minions, and Jayce uses his own Q to clear the wave. At this point, Jayce has the push advantage, and it will be really hard for Kali to get it back without range versus melee matchups work. Since Cuvée can see what's happening, he uses Q a few times along with his Shroud to heal him up and thin the wave as much as he can. We can see the wave is going to eventually crash into the tower now, but his game plan will stay the same. He still wants to thin the wave as much as possible so when it does crash, he doesn't have to last hit 10 minions under tower and take harass for each one. So he uses Q twice, then Shroud, then Q again to clear the cannon and 3 ranged minions. The wave crashes and he takes some harass from Jayce when he goes to last hit. Luckily Jayce misses his shock blast though. If it hit, Cuvée would probably have to base and TP back. But imagine if that was a big wave, he would have to give up a ton of CS or take a ton of harass to get them. Since the wave crashed, this is when Akali can start to get the push back. The waves reset and he uses Q 3 times again on the melee minions. He's level 5 and 60% of the way to level 6, so he wants to get the push. If he lets Jayce push again, he will be too low to make use of his level 6. Now that the wave is in a good spot, he's playing safe and using his Q to get some health back to prepare for mission 3. Right before he hits level 6, he uses Shroud to get some energy back and get some poke in. Then hits level 6 from killing a minion and goes all in, killing Jayce, then dying to Jalea. I'm not going to do a recap for this video because it would be really repetitive and boring, but you can see how Cuvée used his spammable AoE ability to prevent Jayce from shoving him in for the majority of the lane. The only time Jayce got the push was when Lee Sin came to gank and Cuvée tried to bait and took too much damage. But after the wave crashed, he went right back to his game plan and made sure to hit level 6 with enough health to all in Jayce and get the kill. That's going to be all for this video, see you next time.